Attention and down. This is a week number 1, 2, and 3 video for the intermediate class. So we're gonna start with side kicks. So side kicks, we're gonna warm up on the ground. So we'll start on our hands and knees. We'll do 3 rounds of warm up. You know, one for anyone who's an adult like myself, you gotta warm up your lower back and your hips and things. For kids though, this will just teach you the muscle memory to do a proper side kick so you can pass your black belt test one day. So round one, your knee has gotta go in and out like this. If it looks like this, I would actually call that a roundhouse kick, not a side kick. So the knee goes in and out. So let's do 10 with each leg. So here we go, 1, in and out, 2, just kind of warming up, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. In opposite leg, same thing, knee goes in and out, 1, in and out, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Round 2, same idea, but now we're gonna focus on our foot position. A good side kick you should hit with the heel. So stick out your heel. Here we go, 1, focus on that heel. 2, stick out your heel. 3, 4, warming up your leg. 5, 6, 7, stick your heel. 8, 9, 10. Opposite leg, same thing. Stick out the heel. Ready, 1, stick the heel. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. All right, round 3, we're actually gonna stand up. Now we're gonna focus on having our leg flat like the floor, flat like a tabletop. You could just do it to the air like this, like kicking behind you, like a stranger sneaking up behind you. Since I've got a bag right here, I'm actually gonna do it against the bag. So I'm gonna start an arm's distance away, and then I'm gonna look over my shoulder like the stranger's coming. And I want you to focus on, keep your leg as flat as can be. Here we go, let's do 10 of them. 1, just kind of warm it up. 2, 3, flat like a tabletop. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Opposite leg, same thing, our hands are up. Look behind you, make your leg as flat like a table, flat like the floor. 1, 2, 3, like a tabletop. 4, 5, 6, warm it up. 7, 8, 9, and 10. Awesome. So there's 2 kicks we're working on over the next few weeks, lunging side kick and thrusting side kick. So do lunging side kick first. So if I was going to have a bag to hit, so it's like if I was a little too far away and I wanted to sneak in kind of rapidly and get a side kick in. So I take my front leg, I pick it up just a little bit off the ground. So I'm only pushing off my rear leg. As I push off my leg, I'll lunge forward and do a side kick. So let's try it once. If I start a little bit, if I can reach, start a little bit beyond that. See, can I reach? Start to bring your foot off the ground, push off only one leg. You notice one thing I did is when I lunge forward, I actually turn my hips. So my hips are sideways, my butt is facing the target, just like we did during all the warm-ups. So let's do a couple together. So ready? 1. Ready. 2. 3. Pick it up. And lunge. 4. Pick it up. And lunge. One more time. 5. Awesome. Now you should pause the video, do 10 on each side. Emphasize picking your foot off the ground just a little bit first before you go. And as you lunge forward, you get a turn so your butt looks at the target. Of course, hit with the heel, all those kinds of things. The second kick is called thrusting side kick. This is probably the most powerful side kick there is. So it's a little bit like skipping. You probably remember skipping from basic class where you slide up to feet together. Kicks, that's skipping. Thrusting actually goes even a little further. So now I'm gonna start to turn, so my butt looks at the target. I'm actually gonna cross step behind. So it goes further than a skipping kick. So I step behind, and then do the kick. So I get a lot of distance, and I get a lot of power, because my whole body is getting into the kick. So start to turn, so my butt is facing the target. Step behind, and side kick. One more time slower. Another way you can think of it is turn your front heel to the target, which is turning your hips to the target. Step behind. Pop. kick. Let's do five together. Here we go. One, step behind and kick. Woo. I'll try not to smash the mirrors. Here we go. And two, step behind. Thrusting side kick. Ready? Three, step behind. Thrusting side kick. Four, step behind. Thrusting one more time. Five. Now pause the video. Do five on the left side, five on the right side. Most important thing, get your hips facing the target. Step behind as you kick. All those things like we did in the warm-up. Knee goes in and out. Hit with the heel. Keep your leg flat like a tabletop or parallel to the floor. Okay, let's practice the hand skill. So attention and bow. Kicking stance, Lowdy. Up. So we're reviewing the elbow and knee strike set the cycle. My front arm is going to reach out like I'm grabbing the target, like I'm grabbing the stranger by the shoulder like this, or maybe even by the head. So my hand goes in the front. This is like a target. The other one comes up almost like a chicken's wing. If you notice, my hand is this way, not this way. It's kind of like flat to the ground, not like thumbs up. Now this would hit with the muscle, but I'll turn this way like palm down. So I hit with the bone. So I reach this one out. This elbow comes up. Twist and turn, and I'll hit with the bone right into my hand. See, the important thing is you gotta make sure to twist and turn. See, you can even notice my heel comes up off the floor because my hip turns so far into the technique. So reach, chamber, twist and turn, and elbow strike. Ready? One, let's do it together. Two, three, four, five. Awesome, you should pause the video. Do 10 on this side and then also practice 10 on the other side. Make sure your heel is coming up. Make sure your hip is turning into it. Make sure to hit with the bone. So let's do the second elbow strike. That's the dropping elbow strike. So you can reach your arm straight to the ceiling. See, if it's easier to remember, you can point your finger to the ceiling and then you're gonna drop down. So I'm hitting with this elbow, maybe the stranger, maybe I had bent him over doing a knee strike and now pow, maybe I'll finish them off with the elbow strike. So reach up as high as you can and come down. Do you notice both my legs bend? Because I want to drop my center, drop my whole body weight into the technique. So once in a while you'll see someone bending over, but this actually is not good because I'm off balance. I'm not really getting a lot of power, but if I bend with my knees and I drop from my middle, that's how to get power. So reach your arm all the way up and then drop it down. Here we go, ready? One. Two, three, four, five. Awesome. Pause the video. Do 10 on this side and then also 10 on the other side. Making sure bend from your knees, drop your center. That's the important part. No bending over. Okay, the third one is the side elbow strike. So maybe the bad guy's on the side of me. Maybe he's grabbed my shoulder or something. So I'm going to reach my arm all the way across the body. Step sideways into the target towards the bad guy and hit sideways. So I'm still hitting with the back side of my elbow. So reach, step to the side, and elbow strike. Sometimes people forget to shift their weight by stepping. So if it just looks like this, it's kind of powerful. But if you want lots of power, like a black belt, then you gotta step with your leg, shift your entire body weight into the strike. So let's reach across, step this way into the target, just like that. Ready, set, and one, two, three, shift your weight, four, five, awesome. So pause the video, do 10 on this side, and then also 10 on the other side. And like I mentioned, remember to step with your leg, shift with your whole body weight, even your hips and everything, go all into it for more power. Awesome, we have one more technique to practice, is our self-defense. So let's say Mr. Lemke be my partner. So we're learning what's called the twisting or rotation principle. Awesome, thanks. So he's got me from the shirt. Now, I'm not gonna use my arm strength to get out, but I'll use twisting and rotation for my hips. So the way I get out of this is my arm is gonna come up through the middle. My other one's gonna grab from the outside. And I'll grab my hands together. And I won't weave my fingers together. I'll just grab my hands together. And then I'll trap his arm. I'm kind of squeezing it. Then I'll step a little bit so I've got my hips ready to twist and turn to get out. So it's like all of my entire body weight twisting and turning against his wrist. He can try to hold on, but it might really hurt his wrist. Plus we're gonna add distractions in a moment. So
So the arm goes in the middle, grab your hand, trap one arm. Now if I trap this arm, then I gotta spin this way. Once in a while, see a kid do this, they will trap this arm and they'll spin this way. But now you still have another arm. So I guess you could do it twice. Or you know what would be better is just do it correct. Bring it up the middle, grab, trap an arm. So if I trap this one, I've gotta go this way. Or obviously, if I trapped the other arm, then I would just spin this way to get out. That way my twist would get both arms out. So first we just kind of practice that. So maybe pause the video, have mom or dad help by grabbing you by the shirt. You can just memorize how to do this. Now the full technique is verbalize, distract, escape, follow up, disengage. So Mr. Lemke's got me. So first I verbalize, use your words in a strong way. We say, stop, let go, leave me alone. Practice using your voice for confidence. Now, if he's thinking about this, he's really strong. So I'm gonna distract him. I'll do kick into the knee with a front kick, maybe stomp on the foot, maybe knee into the groin, maybe a shin kick. So any of those kind of techniques, because we're right in front of him. And then we get out, since he's a little distracted right now. Now, if I'm really sideways, it might make a lot of sense to do a side kick into his knee and then run. That would be your follow-up. Or when I get out, if I'm a little bit facing him yet, or if my exit's on that side, maybe I'll do palm strikes, then grab knee strikes, maybe that elbow we've been practicing, and then I could run this way. So we should practice both ways, okay? Let's try again. He's got me. So stop, let go, leave me alone. Distract, kick, stomp, knee, any of those kinds of techniques. Twist or rotate to get out. Side kick and run. Or as when I get done, after I get out, palm strikes, grab a hold of him, knee strikes, elbow strikes, and then run. Either way be fine. So pause the video. Now actually practice the whole series. Verbalize, distract, escape, follow up, disengage. The other technique is like, what if he grabs me from behind? He can grab with one arm or two arms. How about, let's start with one arm. So it's a little simpler. So the escaping technique is my elbow comes all the way up. We used to call this the power salute because it almost looks like what we do in the Flying Dragons class, martial arts, America team. So elbow up high. Here's the important part. Watch my foot. It's gonna step behind me and through because now my hips can twist and turn to get out. So I'm not actually using my arm strength like this, but I'm actually using my whole hips and shoulders and my whole body weight as I twist. So I'm actually using the backside of my arm. That's what's gonna push his arm off. It's not actually an elbow strike. So sometimes people think it looks like that, but it's actually not, because it's just gonna, my arm is just gonna push and twist his arm off as I come through. Now, if he was grabbing with two arms, I just do the exact same thing. I step through, it's just now I will knock both of his arms off. Just the same idea. So start with just that. So pause the video, have mom or dad grab from behind with one shoulder or two shoulders grab, and just practice that escape, especially stepping through to twist so you get a lot of power. Now, of course, if he was holding on really strong, I might not even be able to twist if he's holding really rigid, you know? So now we've got to add the verbalize, distract, escape, follow up, disengage. So use your words. We say, stop, let go, leave me alone. Distract. Here's an easy distraction. Kick behind you into the knee. Stomp into the foot. Maybe hammer fist into the groin. Now he's not thinking about this as much as he's thinking about his knee or his foot or pow, or getting hit in the groin. So then I get out. Since I'm facing right at him, probably the easiest follow-up would be palm strikes, knee strikes, elbow strikes, and run. Let's try one more time. So he's got me single or double, doesn't matter. Stop, let go, leave me alone. Distract, 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 escape, follow up, disengage or get away. Awesome, thanks, Mr. Lemke. So pause that video, practice that entire series maybe like 10 times so you got it really good. Okay, last thing, attention and bow, horse riding stance, loud yell, hands in front for a punch. So when I count, your best karate punch. Ready, set, one, two,